Yes, good morning, dear students. Today I will discuss about the heating and humidification process, bypass factor, and the adiabatic mixing process. This is the part of unit 4. The subject name is refrigeration air conditioning, semester 8. This is the today outline: heating and humidification process, bypass factor and contact factor, cooling and dehumidifying coils, ADP of the coils, air washer, mixing process, conclusions. This is the first slide of the today lecture. Heating and the humidification. In the winter air conditioning, heating and humidification are very common. System consists of a coil for a sensible heating of air from the state 1 to 3, then along the wet bulb temperature line through the state 2, then the humidification along the wet bulb line until the required moisture is added to reach. So here in the winter condition, where we want to warm effect because of in the winter condition, heat continuously are losing. So that's why cooling effect are rise in the body. So that's why in the air conditioning system, heating and humidification, this is the system required. The atmospheric air, it is coming from the room sides and the touching in the heating coil where it is warm up. And after the warm up in the heating coil, the raise of the temperature, it is going into the humidifier where humidity is a specific humidity of air can be increased, and after that air will be from the air conditioning system, it will be go into the room. This is the fundamental differences, and this is the fundamental of the heating and the humidification process, and it can be shown into the psychometric chart where the dry bulb temperature and the specific humidity are the clearly shown. This is the one condition air is entering or air it is coming from the outside entering into the heating coil, and after that raising of the temperature it will be of the 0.3, and after the humidification process or entering condition of the room it is the 0.2. So there is a change of temperature after the humidification and heating process. This is the temperature at 0.2. It is showing is here. So 0.2 temperature, it is the less than of the 0.3 and 0.1. 0.1, it is the more than, but 0.3, it is the less than. This is showing in the psychometric chart where the enthalpy can be increased from 0.1 to 0.2 heating and the humidification process. This is the heating process where the without change in the moisture, and this is the process where the humidification is done without the change of the temperature, dry bulb temperature. So heating and humidification, it is represented by the triangle. It is the 1 to 2 process, and enthalpy can be increased here from this point to this point, and the specific humidity can also be increased from W1 to W2. In the saturation curve, there is the relative humidity is the 100%, where the dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, and the dew point temperature are equal. Here it is the wet bulb temperature at 0.1, and here the wet bulb temperature at 0.2, because of the line is inclined on the psychometric chart and it is parallel to each other. So air is coming from this point, mass of air, enthalpy W1 and T1, and the touching in the heating coil with raise of the temperature. After that, it is going into the humidifier where the done by the water, which is passes through the surrounding sides, and coming from this side here, it is the mass of M2, enthalpy of H2, and the specific humidity is the W2, and the temperature will be raised after the humidification will be of T2. Bypass factor and the contact factor for the large commercial system, adopt the simpler and the economical technique. Part of air should be cooled to such a low temperature that the desired mass of moisture is removed. Air at a state 1 is at a much higher temperature than at a state 2. It would work as a heating of the cooled air, hence no extra energy for the heating and the cooling is needed. This type of cooling and the dehumidification is accomplished with the bypass. A part of the inlet air is bypassed without the being cooled, and the rest air is cooled over the coil. तो जो भी पार्ट ऑफ एयर है वो पास की जाती है कूलिंग कॉइल से, और रेस्ट ऑफ द कूलिंग जो एयर रहती है वो कूलिंग कॉइल से निकाल दी जाती है. तो एक्स बाईपास फैक्टर 1 माइनस एक्स अमाउंट ऑफ एयर कूल्ड ओवर द कॉइल फ्रॉम द स्टेट 1 टू टेम्परेचर टीएस ऑफ द कॉइल सरफेस. इट इज द मिक्स अप विद द रेस्ट एयर टू गेट इट ए स्टेट 2 एट ए डिजायर वैल्यू. दिस डिजायर लोएस्ट टेम्परेचर इट एट दिस कॉल्ड द अपटर ड्यू पॉइंट. दिस इज द एडीपी. This is the bypass factor where it is can be air can be drawn from the inlet condition. Here it is the steam is coming from this side and steam is going out this side after the working. And the 1 kg of air at temperature T1, 1 minus of B, this is the bypass air, it is passing through this heating coil, or steam is used for the heating of the coil. And after that, the working air is coming from this manner. This is the picture of the bypass factor where the air can be bypassed. The 1 by B is the amount of air which can be bypassed. It is showing is here, saturation temperature of the cooling coil is a constant, but the temperature after that, it can be decreases in this manner because of after the working, the temperature of the air can be decreased when the air is passing through the cooling coil. This is the bypass air. It is showing in the figure, cooling coil 1 and cooling coil 2. And it is depend on the how much amount of the cooled air is required in the room system. So that's why here the 2 cooling coil is adopted. Bypass factor and the contact factor, it is represented in the psychometric chart where the drive-out temperature in the horizontal axis and the specific humidity is the vertical axis. Here the room temperature can be maintained by the operator dew point. Atmospheric air, it is coming from this point, 1 point, and after the working, it can be attained the temperature of 2. This is the operator dew point, surface temperature of the cooling coil. It is represented by the HS enthalpy form, and H2 is the enthalpy at after the working, and H1 is the starting enthalpy. This is the T1 is the temperature at the atmospheric condition, and after the working and the gaining the temperature of T2, this is the showing of T2 here. And the surface temperature of the cooling coil, it is represented by the TS. The X is the air is passing through the over the system, but 1 minus X is passing through the cooling coil. Similarly, specific humidity, it is represented is here, omega 1, it is a 0.1, omega 2, 0.2, and the omega S is the point S. Thus, one can define a bypass factor of the operators representing the fraction of the uncontacted air in terms of the state 1, 2, and S. X is the bypass factor, that is equal to T2 minus of TS upon T1 minus of TS is equal to omega 2 minus of omega S upon omega 1 minus of the omega S is equal to H2 minus of HS upon H1 minus of the HS. Conversely, one can define a contact factor 1 minus X representing a fraction of the contacted air. Thus, the bypass factor can be defined in terms of the temperature or the specific humidity or enthalpy of air. Cooling and the dehumidifying coil, ADP of the coil, refrigeration is that is out from the another side, refrigeration is in from the lowest side, air is coming from this side and air is out from their side. The rows of the cooling coil, this is arranged in this manner, where air it is after the cooling can be used by the another way. Simple cooling and the spray cooling process, this is represented in the psychometric chart. It is the dry coil and the spray coil, it is represented by the dotted line. Air washer can also be used for the cooling of the required air. Air it is passing through this side, and the damper or the eliminator plates, that is using the purely air which is used in the system, and the air washer, it is the in the form of a spray nozzle. Here it is the washer can be spray in the air, it is coming from the outside. And collection of the water is here at the bottom side. And after that, when the working is completed, air out is completed is here. And makeup water is supplying from their side. External heater or the coil, it is bottom side. And the pump is on the bottom side. This is the mainly after the working of the external heater or the cooler, the air is water is passes through the this spray nozzle as per the requirement. If the heating of air is required, there will be of hot water is supply. If the cooling of air is required, there will be of cooling water is supplied through this pump, and this spray nozzle is passes through spray into the this surrounding air. The air washer flow of air through a spray of water during the course of flow, they are may be cooled or heated or dehumidified depending on the mean surface temperature of the water or the requirement. Just like a requirement rahti uske hisab se wahan pe that may be air may be of the cooled or the heated. Water accordingly externally cooled or the heated or the simply recalibrated by a pump. Eliminator plates are the provided to minimize the loss of water. Droplets of water act as a wetter surface. Both are sensible and the latent heat transfer take place. This is represented in the psychometric chart. The range of the psychometric process with an air washer. This is the 1-2A, 1-2B, 1-2C, 1-2D, 1-2E, 1-2F, 1-2G. So here it is called a heating and the humidification, where the temperature and the humidity both can be increases. Here it is the 1-2B is called a humidification. Only the humidification can be improved, and there will be no chances of the rise of temperature because of the vertical line. 1-2C, that is called a humidification, but the cooling process, it is called the cooling and the dehumidification process, in which process there will be a temperature decrement because of the cooling coil, and humidification is taking place because of the some moisture is added as per the requirement. 1-2D, this is called evaporative cooling. 1-2E is the another way, is the cooling and the dehumidification process, but here it is a lesser amount of the specific humidity can be added. 1-2F, that is called constant dehumidification process, and the cooling process is done. So this is called a sensible cooling, and this is the another way in which the dehumidification and the cooling both are taking place. So these are the processes where the all the techniques can be used for the cooling of the air and the heating of the air taking place. This is called a dry bulb temperature TD, and here it is called a T1. So dry bulb temperature ya aapka jo atmospheric temperature hai, dry bulb ka temperature hai, wo yahan pe show kiya gaya hai. And T-1, this is the temperature is represented is here. The range of the psychometric process within an air washer is represented. Different possible process 1-2A, heating and the humidification, where the surface temperature is greater than the T1, where TS is the mean surface temperature of the water droplet. Mean surface temperature TS is greater than the dry bulb temperature. Here the water is externally heated. Process 1-2B, humidification, where the TS is equal to T1, enthalpy of the air increases, water is required to be externally heated. Process 1-2C, cooling and the dehumidification, where the surface temperature is less than the T1, where is the T1 is the wetter temperature, air is cooled, enthalpy increases as a result of the humidification, water is required to be externally heated. Process 1-2D, adiabatic saturation, T1 is equal to TS, where the T1 is the wet bulb temperature and the pump circulation of water without any external heating or the cooling. Process 1-2E, already discussed, cooling and the humidification process. It is describing in the diagram, psychometric chart. TD, dry bulb temperature is less than the saturation temperature, or the operator dew point temperature is less than the atmospheric temperature. Similarly, process 1-2F, that is called simply cooling, where the surface temperature is equal to the dry bulb temperature, where D is the TD is the dew point temperature, and the water is required to be externally cooled. Process 1-2G, there is a chances of cooling and the dehumidification process in which the surface temperature is less than the dew point temperature, and air is simultaneously cooled and the dehumidified. After that, conclusions. What are the conclusions? There are the number of the method which are the adopted for the cooling and the heating process. And if the spray water is cooled external to the washer, the wet bulb temperature air decreases. If the spray water ka istemal kiya ja raha hai cool karne ke liye aur wo external water ke surrounding mein hai, to jo WBT hai, wet bulb temperature hai, wo air ka decrease hota hai. If the spray water is heated external to the washer, the WBT of air is increases. If the spray water jo hai usko garam kiya ja raha hai external to the washer ke, to WBT jo wet bulb temperature wo increase hota hai. If the spray water is neither heated nor be cooled external to the washer, the WBT of air is not changed. यदि स्प्रे वाटर जो है ना तो गर्म किया जाता है ना ही ठंडा किया जाता है तो डब्ल्यूबीटी जो एयर करता है वो चेंज नहीं होता है. दिस इज द मिक्सिंग प्रोसेस. एडियाबेटिक मिक्सिंग की दो जगह से यदि एयर आ रही है तो उसको हम किस तरीके से यहाँ पे दिखा सकते हैं. तो डिफरेंट एयर फ्लो रेट, इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द टू साइड्स ऑफ द डक्ट, वेयर इट इज कैन बी मिक्स एट द मिक्सिंग चैम्बर और द मिक्सिंग जोन. It is represented in the psychometric chart, where the enthalpy and the dry bulb temperature specific humidity is represented. The mass of air it is supplying from the sides, and here the mass of air too it is supplying from the sides. यहाँ पे जो भी मिक्सिंग हो रही है उस प्रोसेस को तीसरे पॉइंट पे दिखाया गया है। तीसरे पॉइंट पे जो भी एंथालपी रहती है, मिक्सिंग की एंथालपी रहती है, तो मास ऑफ एयर इट इज सप्लाइंग फ्रॉम द दिस साइड एंड द मास ऑफ एयर इज सप्लाइंग फ्रॉम दिस साइड अब मिक्सिंग एट द टेकिंग प्लेस एट द पॉइंट थ्री दिस पॉइंट रिप्रेजेंटिंग द ड्राइव आउट टेम्परेचर एट TD3 एंड स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी ऑल्सो कैन बी चेंजेस फ्रॉम द अकॉर्डिंग टू द एयर कंडीशन विच इज सप्लाइंग फ्रॉम द बोथ साइड ऑफ द मिक्सिंग जोन। दिस इज द ओमेगा 1। इट इज अ स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी एट द पॉइंट 1, स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी एट पॉइंट 2 एंड आफ्टर द मिक्सिंग स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी इन बिटवीन ऑफ द ओमेगा 1 एंड द ओमेगा 2। तो मिक्सिंग प्रोसेस को साइकोमेट्रिक चार्ट में भी शो किया गया है। तो देयर इज अ इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज ऑफ द एंथैल्पी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ द कूलिंग एंड द हीटिंग प्रोसेस कैन बी डन इन द सिस्टम बाय द मॉइस्चर बैलेंस। यहाँ इक्वेशन दिखाई गई है कि जो मिक्सिंग की स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी है वो कैसे हम कैलकुलेट करेंगे। तो जिस तरीके से थर्मोडाइनमिक्स में हमने मिक्सिंग वाला एक पार्ट पढ़ा था, वैसे यहाँ पे मिक्सिंग हो रही है, वहां पे भी स्टीम को हमने दो जगह से पास किया था, वैसे यहाँ पे एयर को पास किया जा रहा है, जिसमें कि मास, स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी, इन सबका एनर्जी बैलेंस दिखाया गया है। तो MA1 ओमेगा 1 प्लस MA2 प्लस ओमेगा 2 इक्वल टू MA3 ओमेगा 3। तो MA3 इट इज द मास ऑफ द मिक्सिंग प्रोसेस, की मिक्सिंग होने के बाद कितना मास है उसकी क्वांटिटी यहाँ पे लिखी गई। ये ओमेगा 3 जो है स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी है। तो ओमेगा 3 इज इक्वल टू MA1 ओमेगा 1 प्लस MA2 ओमेगा 2 अपॉन MA3 वेयर बाय ड्राई एयर मास बैलेंस MA3 इज इक्वल टू MA1 प्लस MA2 बाय एनर्जी बैलेंस द एंथैल्पी ऑफ द मिक्सचर S3 इज इक्वल टू MA1 H1 प्लस MA2 H2 MA3। तो सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द एंथैल्पी, यदि एंथैल्पी के लिए हमें काम करना है तो उसके लिए यहाँ पे जो फंडामेंटल आपके पास इक्वेशंस रहती हैं वो उसका इस्तेमाल करेंगे। CpT3 प्लस HFG ओमेगा 3 इज इक्वल टू MA by MA3 MA1 by MA3 इन द ब्रैकेट ऑफ द CpT1 प्लस HFG ओमेगा 1 प्लस MA2 by MA3 बिकॉज ऑफ द डिवाइडिंग ऑफ द टेकिंग प्लेस बोथ साइड CpT2 प्लस HFG ओमेगा 2। दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द एंथैल्पीज। सिंप्लीफाइंग द एक्सप्रेशंस, जो एक्सप्रेशन आपका प्रीवियस स्लाइड में दिखाया गया था उसको यदि हम सिंप्लीफाइड करेंगे तो उस केस में आपके पास T3 की वैल्यू इस फॉर्म में निकल के आएगी। द सेकंड टर्म इन द अबव एक्सप्रेशन बीइंग द नेगलिजिबल, वी कैन राइट T3 इज इक्वल टू MA1 T1 प्लस MA2 T2 अपॉन MA3। यदि आप याले इक्वेशन के इधर वाले प्लस के इधर वाले यदि आप इस चीजों को इग्नोर कर देते हैं तो आपके पास इक्वेशन ये बचेगी। कंक्लूजन, हियर इट इज आल्सो इफ द वाटर इज कूल्ड एक्सटर्नल टू द वाटर द WBT ऑफ द एयर डिक्रीजेस। If the spray water is heated external to the washer, the WBT of air increases. If the spray water is neither heated or cooled external to the washer, the WBT of air is not changed. So this is the today lecture. Thank you. If you have any doubt, please ask me.